Today, we 3D print an AirAssist solution for the K40 laser cutter. A few weeks ago, we bought this Chinese K40 laser cutter on eBay and made a video on how to set it up. If it cuts wood or cardboard, the material could catch fire. So let's build a device to improve safety, an AirAssist. This simple device is constantly blowing out the flame. Most people use compressed air with the AirAssist, but we wanted to see if we can get away using one of these fans, as they are cheaper and not so noisy. We created a model in Fusion 360 that was too large in quite a few areas. Also, the cone at the bottom snapped off and the model was somehow screwed up so that it wasn't possible to fix the parameters easily. With new measurements, we recreated the model in OpenSCAD. The main body is just a combination of cubes and cylinders. That kind of object can be created easily in OpenSCAD. The cone was modeled as a separate object in order to make it easier to print. On the CR10 printer, we have to add supports for the cone to ensure proper bed adhesion. After the cone is printed, we also print the main body. I will leave a download link in the description if you want to print the model yourself. The cone has a lip at the top that makes it easy to center it on the main body and glue it in place. We also glue a metal thread insert in the hole at the front. With a drill and a file, we taper the tip of an M4 machine screw so that it fits in the groove at the laser head and will hold the contraption in place. The last thing we add is the fan. It is secured by two screws and any gaps are filled with hot glue. Crimping a connector on the cable of the fan will make installation and maintenance easier than soldering the connection. On Thingiverse, we found a nice drag chain with connectors for the K40. We printed this one and installed it so that we can route the cable in a protective fabric mantle through the drag chain in the electronics compartment. The end of the drag chain gets secured with a zip tie so that the drag chain doesn't get in the way of the laser. For power supply, these two connectors offer 24 volt. We can connect the step-down board and adjust the voltage to 12 volt. The board is mounted to this quick print with two threaded inserts, which is then hot glued to the case. Two LED strip leftovers from a previous project are also connected to the 12 volt power source, which is improving the lighting in the case massively. After using the AirAssist for a few test cuts, I realized that thin paper is easier to cut without the AirAssist. With a simple switch soldered to a longer set of wires, it's now possible to switch the fan on or off. This was another step to improve the cut quality of the laser and make it safer. We tested it with different materials and it seems to work great. Also check out my other laser-related videos. Next on the list are an upgrade of the bed and a few more safety-related improvements. If you don't want to miss these, please subscribe and follow me on Instagram for a look at future projects.